ready for baseball under the roof in Houston. Here it's the little guys on the big stage between the Sugarland Skeeters and the Scranton Wilkes-Barre Rail Riders.
Ladies and gentlemen, your Scranton Wilkes-Barre Rail Riders.
Now at the plate, here is Ross Adolph, and we are ready for some daytime baseball. Here it comes on 1-1. Lifted the other way down the left field line. Frazier is right there as he puts it away, no problem for the first down. So bases are empty with one gone, and into bat next, the utility man extraordinaire Marwin Gonzalez. Down 3-2.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
LoCastro waits on it. He hauls it in without any trouble, and there are two away. So now to the plate, Ronnie Dawson. First chance for him here in the top of the first with nobody on. The 1-1. Opposite field to left. Frazier gets there for the catch, and that ends the inning. Striding in is Tim LoCastro. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. The 1-2. Lifted down the line in left. Left fielder is on the move. He makes the catch, a great effort to get there and record the first out of the inning. Now with the plate is Andrew Velasquez, as he'll dig into the left-handed batter's box.
And this isn't his strong side, at least not in terms when you look at the stat sheet or his consistent contact rates. I just don't think he's quite as smooth with his rhythm and swing mechanics when he's hitting left-handed.
And there's ball three on a breaking ball that misses away. Chris Gittens is on deck. Yeah. Fastball in there, 3-2.
Counts full.
And a swing and a miss as they got him with the slider there, two away. Next up is Chris Gittens, looking to get on base and keep this first inning alive. Gittens. Fouled off. Bases are empty here with two men out. And another foul ball. That's off the end of the bat foul, and he might have been fortunate to stay alive that time. Now another 1-2.
Two balls,
well, I
two
think
strikes.
That pitch is the result of a lot of foul balls. He might have tried to do a little bit too much with it, trying to get him to swing through it.
A swing and a miss. That retires the side, and that will do it. And now here is Taylor Jones. He'll get us started in the top of the second. The 1-1 is looked at for ball number two.
Hasn't seen a heater yet in this at bat. One might be coming right here.
Ball even at 2-2.
Well, somebody's sitting off speed right here. Only way he was late on that heater is he was expecting another changeup.
Fouled away. 2-2. He is swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. So next to hit is number 13. He stands in for the first time in this
one.
And he'll back him off a bit with a fastball in, but it's 3-1 now. And it's up to a 3-2 full count now.
Hey, there was great arm action on that 3-1 changeup right here. He's got this guy thinking. That's the beauty right now. We go to a full count. Do you sit changeup, or do you stay with the heat?
Got him to go down swinging there. Number 13 goes down for out number 2 in the top half. And that's ball three now as it just misses below the zone. Good swing on a tough pitch, and he'll stick around to see another one. Another full count pitch home. Hit sharply on the ground. A diving effort here as he gets a glove on it. And no chance at all to make a play here, so despite the effort, the inning will continue.
The shortstop,
at the plate for Yudis Nova. And he takes ball three, so it's a full count now.
Good spot for an RBI. Put the ball in play with the runner in motion. He could score all the way from first.
And this pitch misses for ball four. So that's going to move a runner into scoring position now with two away. So now here is Robel Garcia looking to put them ahead early with this at bat. And this one's high and tight, backing him up 2-1.
2-1.
Has to be a challenge pitch coming up here. He probably doesn't want to flirt with loading the bases.
And a check swing here as he couldn't help himself, and it's ruled strike two. A swing and a ground ball to third. Scooped up, and the inning will end as they're unable to cash in with two outs. Half of the second set to go, and digging in is the outfielder Clint Frazier. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Oh, and he clobbers this one, but this is going to be a foul ball as it clears the wall. Here's another 1-2. Now here's a fly ball, well hit. And he's going to have room to put this one away, and that's the first out. So the next to bat will be Aaron Hicks.
Aaron Hicks.
2-2.
Full count.
Lifted in the air to center field. Dawson is back, and he'll get there to make the play for route number two. So two out, nobody on, and it brings Esteban Florial in at the plate. Bottom of the second here with no score. This is in the air out to straightaway center. Dawson gets under it and makes the catch to end the inning. Now in the box, Garrett Stubbs, as we are all set to begin the third inning in this one. The 2-1. Runs a bit inside for a ball.
The offense better get it going right here, because they certainly can tell from their dugout this guy is carrying himself with a presence out on the mound. He's got a feel for all his pitches.
Grounded to first. And he'll take it to the bag himself for the out. So next to bat will be Ross Adolph. He flew out in his last debut. Here's the 1-1 pitch. A ball and two strikes.
1-2, the count.
Wow, great pitch right there, right? Changing speeds. How about that straight changeup? How about that swing? Howdy, if you're waving at me.
Two balls and two strikes now. Here now the 2-2.
Got a full count.
Third inning, no score to this point. And this misses for ball four. The second walk he surrendered here in the first three innings. One out, runner at first, and into bat next, the utility man extraordinaire Marwin Gonzalez. But the runner's back easily. And he fouls this one off.
Adolph leads off first with one away.
Just staying alive, putting together a really good at-bat here.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating, feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
Neither guy giving in here, and they'll do it again.
Hey, have an AB right here. I know it's frustrating the heck out of the pitcher. You keep fouling these pitches off, maybe one misses over the heart of the plate.
Donnie finally wears him down here as he strikes him out after a 9-pitch at-bat. Next to hit, Ronnie Dawson, 0-for-1 here in the early going. Even at a ball and a strike, here's the pitch.
Ball.
A runner on first with two away. All even now, 2-2.
That's a real nice location with that fastball up and in on the hands. Hard to do much with that because a hitter really can't extend his arms very easily.
Hoping to send him packing, pitch on its way. And this one runs in on him as he can't get his arms extended. A great pitch there, and the inning is over. Here's Miguel Andujar now. Down the first baseline, reined in, and a step on first himself for the out. Digging in will be Mandy Alvarez. Bottom of inning number three, nothing, nothing our score. No offer on that one, two balls and a strike.
2-1 to count.
And it's fouled away.
Not surprised he's laid on a heater right there. Just saw an off-speed pitch. Wanted to stay back a little bit too long.
No offer on that one, and Verlander's run at full down, 3-2. Fouled off. And now a slider in there for a called third strike, and there are two gone now.
Batting done.
Now to bat, Rob Brantley.
Wrong.
Outside part of the plate, the changeup is in there. Tough curveball that time, but he's able to make a little contact to keep this at-bat going. Curveball grounded towards second. Gonzalez is up with it. Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first saves an error as the side is retired. All set for the start of the fourth, and here comes the first baseman, Taylor Jones.
I know we're not seeing a lot of offense in this one, but there's still some game left. I'm looking to see these guys, offenses, make some notable adjustments at the dish and try and scratch a few runs across.
And he lays off there, ball four. So the leadoff man is on here to begin stanza number four.
The batter.
Next to dig in, number 13, 0-for-1 for him here in this one. Even at a ball and a strike, here's the pitch.
That's the ball.
Boy, not exactly what you'd like as a pitcher. One of the keys is to minimize your pitches, attack the strike zone early, a lot of deep counts, and working himself into a lot of trouble.
Ground ball sent back up the middle. He's got it. The second for one. The relay not in time as he beats the throw by a step.
Now back.
Next to hit is Jordan Brewer. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Hicks is under it, and he brings it in for the second out of the inning. Stepping up is Freudis Nova. Pitching has the upper hand early as we're scoreless in inning number four. And he popped him up. LoCastro ranging into the outfield. He's there to make the play, and that'll retire the side. Now back to the top of the lineup, stepping in, Tim LoCastro. He's 0 for 1 thus far. And a foul pop behind the plate. Stubbs is there, one away. So here is Andrew Velasquez, struck out in his last trip to the plate. Bases are empty, one man out. Now a swing and a miss at a slider for a strike.
Hey, that was a nasty pitch right there. Ton of rotation on that ball. You could almost see the red dot from up here. Nasty depth.
Full count, 3-2. High pop up. Number 13 is calling for it. Makes the play, and there are two gone now. Digging in next, Chris Gittens. He went down on strikes in his last at bat. Two out, nobody on. Called strike on the inside, and he can't believe it at the plate. It's 1-2 now. And they'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in the dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2. Waved at and missed for the third out. Not much of a chance at hitting that one, and the inning is over. To the plate now is the designated hitter, Rubel Garcia. He'll start off the fifth in this one. And he misses this one inside, and that'll run things full, 3-2.
You do not want to walk the eight-hole hitter. It just opens up so many options. Do we bunt them over to second with the nine-hole hitter? Do we try and play for that big rally with the top of the order coming up? This is a huge pitch. You can't allow this guy to walk.
So he punches him out, looking at the fastball. Rubel Garcia goes down for the first out in the fifth inning. Oh, and he can't catch up to the fastball as he swings and misses for the second out. Now to the plate, here is Ross Adolph trying to avoid becoming the third strikeout victim of the inning here. 1-2.
1-2.
That's how you open up the outside part of the plate. Pound two balls in, and they get right back outside. Nice pitch.
Looked like the fastball got away from him there. It's ball two.
2-2.
We just saw a fastball right there. I would not be shocked if he tries to get this guy to go fishing right here and drops a little off-speed pitch in the dirt.
Bases are empty here with two men out. Fouled away. Hit on the ground to third. And he goes to a knee to try to knock it down, but it's by him down the line. Standing in now, Marwin Gonzalez. Now here's a ball hit high and deep to straightaway right field. Florio retreats to the track, and he'll put this one away. So a sigh of relief as the side is retired. Ready to go for the last half of the inning, and that'll bring up the outfielder Clint Frazier. And the perfect game will go by the wayside here as this pitch misses for ball four.
Center fielder.
Digging in, switch hitter Aaron Hicks. Flied out in his first at bat, so making 0 for 1 so far. Still 1-2 as he fouls it away. Two balls and two strikes to Hicks now. Frazier on at first, nobody out. Lifted into the air out towards center field. Dawson will settle under it to make the play for the first out as the runner will have to head back to first. Next to stand in is Esteban Florial. Flew out last time up. He's set. Here comes the 1-1.
No, that's
get the target, but this is low, 2-1.
Hey, he threw that pitch with a purpose to get a double play. Good job to let it go by, though, as a hitter.
Hi-ya! 2-2.
Love the fact the pitcher challenged him in that spot right there. Didn't love the location. But I got to be honest with you, I think he's got him on his heels right now. Don't be shocked if he attacks his zone again.
Full count now. Now the payoff pitch home. And awfully close there on 3-2, but take your base, says Earl Hendricks. It's ball four.
The designated hitter.
Next will be the designated hitter, Miguel Andujar. He's 0-1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. No offer on that one, and Verlander's run at full now, 3-2. Gonzalez for one on to first as they get the double play to get him out of the inning. Now at the plate, Ronnie Dawson. He's set to lead us off in the sixth inning. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Good idea with the change, but it's 2-1. And he just gets a piece there as this is chopped foul. Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch. Slow grounder to first. Fielded cleanly. Throw to first gets him, so the leadoff man's retired here to begin the sixth. So now it'll be the four-hole hitter, Taylor Jones. It was a walk in his last trip. Here now the 2-2. Swing, and he launches this one to deep left field. Into the Crawford boxes and gone. Nick Nelson. 6'1" right-hander will be the one to get the call from the bullpen here.
Number 79.
Stepping in now, number 13. It's 1-2. To two balls and two strikes now. The 2-2. Gets him swinging. He struck him out. Now into the box, Jordan Brewer. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. And he checks his swing. Did he go around? Yes, says the first base umpire. Strike two. The 1-2. Ground ball right side. And the inning will continue as that's through for a two-out hit.
The bat, number one, shortstop, Freudis Nova.
In now, Freudis Nova. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Left fielder giving chase. He tracks it down, and that will end the inning. Plate now is Mandy Alvarez. First time up, he went down looking.
Yeah, Matty, and hopefully he got it out of his system. Especially now, he's got a bear down. He gets the two strikes in this spot. Has to put the ball in play.
2-2 the count. Into the windup and the pitch. High in the air out to center field. Dawson is there, and he has it for the first out. Now it'll be Rod Brantley comes into this at bat 0-1 in the ballgame. One out, nobody on. High in the air down the right field line. And that will end up a foul ball. And a fastball swung on and missed as he just reared back there. Two away.
Now back.
So the lineup flips over and digging in, Tim LoCastro. In his last at-bat, he popped out in foul ground.
Yeah, but everything looked clean. He was on time. He looked powerful in the box. I guarantee you he wants that swing back. He's still thinking about it as he walks to the plate right here.
Even count, two balls and two strikes. Skied into straightaway right. No trouble for him as he makes the catch to end the inning.
So stepping in is Robel Garcia. He's 0 for 2 with a strikeout in this one. The 1-2 is an off-speed pitch taken for a ball. Fastball called, strike three, and there's the first out of the inning. Ready now is Garrett Stubbs. He struck out swinging in his last trip to the plate.
Yeah, and kind of shocked he got blown away with a fastball. You could tell he was late on that one. And we'll see if he tries to cheat to something this AB.
I think it's about time to choke up on that bat and get that foot down. He's awfully tardy right now.
And he fouls this one off. Another 1-2 delivery. There's a fastball well off the plate for a ball. And this will miss down low in the third, so he's worked it full now at 3-2. Now the payoff pitch home. Here's a pop up now, and this is going to get down. It's a foul ball. Locked in a good battle. Here comes another one. Again, he sends it out of play. Once again, a 3-2. And he takes ball four. So a good job out of the nine hole in getting on base as we go back to the top of the order.
The right fielder.
So now into the box is Ross Adolph, singled last time up. And it's fouled away. The 1-2. Misses for the second ball. Stubbs, a runner at first with one gone in the inning. Swing and a miss on the changeup, and there are two gone. Here's Marwin Gonzalez now.
The batter number nine, second baseman, Marwin Gonzalez.
Now the 1-1 pitch is in there for strike number two.
Hey, I still believe in my heart the best pitch is a well-executed fastball down and away, and that's exactly what that is. He swings at that. That's off the end of the bat. That's not hard contact at all, and that's an easy out for the defense.
Fouled off. Here's another 2-2. That misses, and it's going to set up a big pitch now. 3-2.
3-2, two out, runner on first. Lots of possible outcomes on this pitch.
Now the payoff pitch home. High fly ball out to deep right field. Florial on the run to the track. And this one is gone. A home run. So now to the plate, Ronnie Dawson. On the ground up the middle. And there's his first base hit in this one.
Now batting, the first baseman, Taylor Jones.
Into the box now, Taylor Jones. Fly ball out toward left center field. Hicks is under it. And that's the third out.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's time for the traditional seventh inning stretch.
Last half of the seventh here, and that'll bring up the switch hitting shortstop, Andrew Velasquez. Neither guy willing to give in, and the at bat will continue. Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch. Nasty breaking ball swung on in the dirt. And the throw is there to record the first out. Now to the play, Chris Gittens, who was sat down on strikes in his last at-bat.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there north of seven, eight-pitch ABs, Sometimes it just comes down to pure execution. Let's see if he makes the adjustment right here.
Got him. So that's the second out of the inning, and he's seven outs away now. Two out, nobody on. And they'll come back with one in the dirt as the count moves to 2-1 now.
Well, that's not where he wanted that curveball. It kind of backed up and stayed in. That could be effective sometimes, but it usually doesn't have the same hard bite.
No offer on that one, and Verlander's run at full now, 3-2.
And it's late to his afternoon of work, and the longer this at bat goes, the better chance of him making a mistake. But as a guy starts to...
Well, the play's been made, and with it comes the end of the inning. Into the box, number 13, 0-for-3 with a couple of strikeouts for him to this point in the ballgame. Now the 2-1 pitch. Hit the other way out toward right field. Florial on the run. He gets there to make the play for the first out of the inning.
Now back.
Next up, Jordan Brewer. Swung on and lifted in the air to left center. And he will make the play out there, and there are two away now. And now for Yudis Nova, 0-for-2 from him so far in this one. Here's the 1-1 pitch. Good change of speeds, but he lays off 2-1. This is lifted out to left. Frazier will reach out with one hand to make the catch on the move, and that ends the inning. Stepping in once again is Aaron Hicks, 0-for-2 here to start the afternoon. The 1-2. Swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. Next, here is Esteban Florial. It was a walk in his last trip.
Florial.
The 1-1.
2-1.
Lifted the other way down the left field line. Left fielder is on the move. And he tracks it down. A nice running play to record the second out. And that'll bring up Miguel Andujar.
The designated hitter, Miguel Andujar.
The 2-2 is laid off, and the count runs full. Mandy Alvarez would be next. And he struck him out. So he's now through 8 full innings and will take his no-hit bid into the ninth. Striding forward now is the DH, Rubel Garcia. He'll start things off in the top of the ninth as they look for a little insurance. And a slider's in for a strike. It's 2-2. Stays alive, still 2-2. Into the windup and the pitch. He jumps on this one. It's high and deep to center. And that'll get down out there for extra bases. Around second. He's on his way to third. And he is into third with a leadoff triple. Tyler Lyons, a 6-foot-2-inch left-hander, jogs in to take over on the hill. Into the box, Garrett Stubbs. Late on that one as it's fouled off to the left side.
The offensive approach here is simple. You know the pitcher's going for the K, so set your sights middle of the plate. And then don't worry about the infielders. They're so close, hard contact is a guaranteed ribbon.
On a good changeup, a swing and a miss, and he's set down on strikes for the second time today.
The white fielder covers
Up next, Ross Adolph. Though they might pitch around him here with a couple of bases empty. Hit out towards second. On to first, and there were two down. Ready to take his hacks again, Marwin Gonzalez blasted a two-run homer in his last at-bat.
Going back to that last AB, that was the express. That was an upper 90s fastball that he turned around. So I think with this guy, you might want to try to incorporate some more off-speed pitches.
Hey, find a way right here. Two outs, this guy has come in throwing bullets. If he can get this team into the dugout right here with another donut and they regroup, start passing the baton a little bit.
And that'll bring home another as they open it up to a 4-0 advantage now.
Now back.
Standing in now, Ronnie Dawson. Gonzalez is off of first with two away. Good eye to lay off the slider there, and he works it to full 3-2 here.
Now on 3-2 as a pitcher, you've got to go with the pitch that you feel most comfortable throwing with.
Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact. And he struck him out, so a good pitch there, and now they're going to need to string some hits together in this last at-bat if they want to get back in this thing. Now at the plate here is Mandy Alvarez. No hits in two trips to the plate for him in the ballgame. Now the 2-1. Can't find the zone there, and it's 3-1.
Great AB up until this point. A walk right here could really just infuse some confidence into this lineup.
And could this be the start? It's a long way back, but the leadoff man is on base to start their final set of at-bats. Oh, had a hanger that time, but missed it. 1-2. Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. Fouled away.
If you're on the mound right here, why not continue to climb the ladder if he's going to continue to swing at it?
Good plate discipline to lay off the slider that time, and he draws even a 2-2.
What we're seeing here is a really smart at bat. They got to be thinking the man on the mound is getting a little short on gas, so when you go up there and make him throw a bunch of pitches, you're more likely to get a good pitch to hit or at least force him out of the game.
Ready with another two-strike offering. And he struck him out for route number one. So now just two outs away from the no-no. Pedro Baez enters from the bullpen, hoping to get the final two outs and put this one into the win column. Here's the 2-2 pitch. A great pitch there as he couldn't get extended on that one, and he's down on strikes for the second out.
The batter.
Next, it'll be Andrew Velasquez. He is the last man to stand in the way of possible history here this afternoon. A bouncer up the middle. A dive, and he knocks it down. And the recovery throw will be too late for the force at second, so that'll be scored an infield hit, and there are two on with two away now. Stepping in now, Chris Gittens. And he fouls this one off. Has them down to their final strike. Here it comes.
Full count.
Great take right there, but the last thing you want to do is be called out on strikes to end the game.
Eighth pitch of the at-bat coming up. Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. A shot to left field and deep. Look at this. It's up and out of here into the archways. Andre Stroud takes the ball now in inning number 9, looking to close the door.
throw.
To the plate now, Clint Frazier. Can't keep the weight back, and he falls behind 1-2. Close, but it's not over yet. That's ball two. Popped him up. Stubbs is under it. Makes the catch, and that's the ball game.
Well, that's just a great job of battling on the road. They fought all the way to the end, took the lead in the top of the ninth, and secured the W in the bottom half. That's a great team win.
A one-run finish, 4-3, the final tally today. The Skeeters rode an important sixth inning to victory in this one. Justin Verlander is the winning pitcher of record. So that'll just about do it. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. This has been a presentation of MLB The Show. For more, don't forget to check out theshow.com.
Fans, our final line score. First for the victorious Skeeters, 4 runs on 8 hits. No errors, they left 8 men on base. For the Rail Riders, 3 runs on 2 hits. No errors, they left 2 men on base. Time of the ball game, 3 hours and 1 minute.